Hello everybody, this is Sonic Smash here, and here is another video on the Zelda timeline. Now, if you're watching this video, I assume you've seen my other one. If you haven't, go ahead, see that one. Do that. Okay, well, anyway, in my previous video, I talked about my problems with the Zelda timeline and what I would do to improve it. And I have been requested to make a video on that theory that I have. So, I'm going to read you my theory of what really happened in the timeline. It's based off Nintendo's Hyrule Historia. There's not too many changes. It's mostly just a run-through of what the timeline is. So, it begins with the creation of Hyrule, with three golden goddesses, with Din, Pharaoh, and Nehru creating the world. Din created the geography, Nehru created the law, Pharaoh created all life. Yeah, we all know that story. And then they entrusted the Triforce to the goddess Hylia. So, and then Demise, the evil being Demise, came out of the earth with his army of monsters trying to take the Triforce from Hylia. So Hylia got all the humans on an outcropping of land, sent it to the sky along with the Triforce and the Goddess Sword, and then fought with Demise and sealed them away, and that's the Demise War. Then the events of Skyward Sword happens. I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but basically, here's what's up afterward. So Demise is killed, and he says that his malice and the ones with the blood of the goddess and spirit of the hero would be reborn in an endless cycle. So all that stuff. So, yeah, Demise is dead, and the people on Skyloft rediscovered the surface and sort of go out, and the place has come to be known as Hyrule. Okay. Then we have the Era of Chaos, where apparently there's some big war thingy, and that has to do with the Sacred Realm and the Triforce. And I assume this is where the Interloper War that's mentioned in Twilight Princess happens, where the Dark Interlopers are using their evil stuff, like the Fuse Shadow, and I think actually Majora's Mask, too. So the Light Spirits, which I assume are like the Skyward Sword Dragons, kind of reborn in a new body, sealed them away, and because of this, the sages decided to seal off the Sacred Realm from the rest of the world. Also, following that is the Era of Prosperity, where those with the blood of the goddess Hylia, reborn as Zelda, established the kingdom of Hyrule. And that's when Hyrule Castle, the Temple of Time, that's when all this was born, and it was basically the founding of the entire Hyrule Kingdom. And now we have the story of the Hero of Men, where the Hero of Men saved Hyrule from the evil darkness beasts, and had the Picory Blade, sealed them in the bound chest, and had the Light Force, which he gave to the royal family for them to pass down to the princesses. And of course, I don't know, 100 years later, is the Minish Cap. And all those events happen, Body tries to look for the Light Force, it was in Zelda the whole time. And then Link has his hat. Oh yeah, and he establishes the Four Sword. I should probably mention that. So the Four Sword is now established here. And that's the Minish Cap. I don't think they actually reveal what happens to Body in this time. I don't think they ever do. But I assume he was sealed into the Four Sword. And then we have what I call the Four Sword Legend, which is the backstory of Four Swords, which I believe not to be the same thing as the Minish Cap, where apparently Vadi escapes again and starts, and he doesn't have any memory of him, of the Light Force or his time or anything in the Minish Cap. So he starts, he calls himself the Great Sorcerer of the Wind and starts stealing beautiful maidens. And then a mysterious boy with a four sword comes trotting along and has to defeat Vati. And people were so fascinated how, if, like, all the knights who tried to stop him couldn't do it, why the boy could. And the maidens told him because of the sword's magical power that it can turn one into four. They didn't believe it, but called it the Four Sword nonetheless, and they built a shrine to protect it. Now, what I think would happen is that this is like a game that hasn't come out yet, something like that, that features a different Link, and that Vati escaped from the seal, and he took the Four Sword that he was supposed to be sealed in and went after him, and eventually. I don't know, it's pretty similar to Four Swords in terms of plot, but there might be some cool mechanics that I've been thinking about. But enough of speculation of new games. Now, in the original timeline, this is where Four Swords happens. But for now, I'm going to take Four Swords out of here. Four Swords won't go here. That's because of the backstory of Four Swords Adventures, and considering how Ocarina of Time, what I liked him to be the very first Ganondorf. So I'm not going to put Four Swords here because Four Swords Adventures is gonna have to follow it. So instead we have the Hyrule Unification War, which is the great civil war that we barely know anything about. And that's when Link, Hero of Time, is born. And then the events of Ocarina of Time happen. And it splits two ways, not three, two. Now you're probably thinking, oh, it's just another timeline that was made before Hyrule Historia, and he's just adding it on now. But no, it does. No, but the third timeline is there, and I'll get to it. But for now, we have the two timelines, the child and adult timelines. So start with the child timeline. Child timeline, so here Link, the Hero of Time, has just come back from 7 years, and he warns Zelda about Ganondorf, and they catch him red-handed. And I don't know what he did exactly that makes him be executed, but I don't know. He's scheduled for execution. Anyway, and I assume it's a couple months, maybe a year later, Majora's Mask happens. And that's when Link goes off to find Navi and ends up going to Termina and basically has nothing to do with the timeline as a whole. So, a couple years later, Ganondorf is going to be executed. However, due to some what they call divine prank, I'm sure they're going to explain this maybe some way, but what they don't know is that Ganondorf actually has the Triforce of Power in the Child timeline, which I don't understand why he has it. I mean, it's never really been shown. He just kind of has it. I don't know. Maybe it's just some Nintendo excuse. But whatever it is now, Ganondorf is instead sealed into the Twilight Realm from the Mirror of Twilight. Then the events of Twilight Princess happens, and at the end, the Ganondorf from Ocarina of Time dies. So he's dead, with the Master Sword in him. And then here's what I call the taking of the Trident, is that this is like, I don't know. Like I said, hundreds of years. Anything can separate these, really. But hundreds of years later, there's a new Ganondorf who's born into it. And he goes into the Desert of Doubt and steals the Trident of Power and the Dark Mirror. Which I don't think is the Twilight Mirror. I think every mirror is different. Which is different from what I originally thought, but right now, I think every mirror is different. Okay. Then Four Swords happens. Like this, it moved here because in the manual of Four Swords Adventures, it mentions the events of Four Swords happens like 6 months before. So I'm putting it here. Four Swords happens. Vati escapes again. And I assume in this 6 month period after Four Swords ends, but before Adventures, this is when Ganondorf hears about it and concocts the plan that he's going to make Shadow Link and then trick Link into releasing Vaadi and then use both of them as puppets to end up taking over the world. And long story short, everything fails. And Ganondorf here, I believe, yes, he's sealed into the Four Sword. And this is where the Child Timeline ends. So there is a possibility that in a later game in the Child Timeline, he will escape from the Four Sword. I don't know if that game will involve the Four Sword at all. It might. We don't know. It's Nintendo's decision. But yeah, for now, that's the end of the Child Timeline. Now we have the Adult Timeline from Ocarina. And it starts out with the Era Without a Hero, and that's when Ganondorf escapes from the Dark World. And the Hero of Time isn't there to save him, because he's over in the Child Timeline doing all of his other stuff. And so the goddesses decide to flood Hyrule, because there's really no one ready to save them. And then 100 years later is the Era of the Great Sea. This is when Hyrule is all flooded, and this is when the Wind Waker and Phantom Hourglass happens. So basically here's what happens. The Ganondorf from Ocarina of Time ends up dying. Or we think he dies. He only turns into stone. And he's under the Great Sea. So maybe in a later game in the Adult Timeline, he could rise up from the sea again. Just like he did in Wind Waker. But anyway, Wind Waker and Phantom Hourglass happens. Then they find the new Hyrule, the new Hyrule continent. And literally 100 years later, that's when Spirit Tracks happens. In this new Hyrule with Maladus. Oh yeah, it's interesting to notice that, to note right here, in Skyward Sword, Demai says that his mouse will be reincarnated into different forms. And that doesn't mean just Ganondorf. It could mean Bellum and Maladus are both Demise's malice reborn. Whatever. But for now at least, that's the end of the Adult Timeline.